Hello, welcome to the weekly technical analysis review here at XM.com. I'm Rafi Boyajian, currency analyst, and today's Monday, September 4th, 2017. Today we will look at the dollar yen, the euro dollar, the pound dollar, and the Aussie dollar. So let's start with the dollar yen pair. We can see here in the daily chart, the pair has been fairly neutral over the medium term. At the moment, we do see some downside risk given that the 50-day moving average has dropped below the 200-day one. If we move on to the 4-hour chart, we can see that at the moment it's looking fairly neutral in the short term as well, with prices moving around the 50 moving average, and we do see a fairly good signal coming from the Fibonacci retracement of the down leg from 114 to 49 point, 108.26. At the moment, prices are trading around the 23.6% Fibonacci level. We can see there's a strong congestion around that area. At the moment, it will probably it is acting as a resistance. The next resistance will likely come from the 200 MA at around 110.24, followed by the 38.2% Fibonacci level. And that's also an important one. We can see that's been previously acted as resistance several times around that level. If prices do manage to break above the 38.2% Fibonacci level, it should give momentum for prices to rise towards the 111 level, and then above that, it should bring into view the 50% Fibonacci level. A rise above the 50% Fibonacci level would strongly shift the bias to a positive one. To the downside, we have been seeing strong support coming from the 108 level back in April. It did touch a low of 108.12. It did come close to that level back in August, touching a 4.5 month low. So a drop below the 108.26 could accelerate the declines towards 108.12, and then that would significantly shift the medium-term outlook to a negative one. Let's move on to the euro-dollar pair now. We can see in the daily chart here that the shallow uptrend we saw at the start of the year quickly turned to a much steeper uptrend starting in May. Of course, prices are still very much trading within that channel, despite recent signs of consolidation. We can see euro dollar has dropped to the lower half of that linear regression channel. Looking at the 4-hour chart now, we can see there is resistance coming from the 38.2% Fibonacci level of the down leg from 1.2069 to 1.1822. A break above that level should open the way towards the 50% Fibonacci level at around 1.1945, followed by the 61.8% Fibonacci level at 1.1975, and then after that, we could see prices once again targeting 1.20 handle, and then August 2.5 year high of 1.2069. The next key level about 1.2069 would come from the 161.8% Fibonacci level at 1.2220. To the downside, there is immediate support coming from the 50 moving average at about 1.1888. Below that, just below that, we have, of course, the 23.6% Fibonacci level. And a drop below that would see prices nearing the low we saw on August 31st of 1.1822. A drop below that, we should see prices coming close to the lower linear regression channel, which also happens to be corresponding with the 200 moving average. So that this line here should act as a key support level. At the moment, that support is coming around the 1.1750. Moving on to cable now, we can see pound dollar has recovered from the 8-week low we saw back in August of 1.2773. They actually touched a 3-week high on Friday of 1.2995. Prices have moved back below the 50 moving average at the moment, but it is trending inside the Ichimoku cloud, suggesting a neutral outlook in the medium term. In the short term, in the medium term, it's a little bit bullish. We can see the 50 MA remains above the 200 MA, and we've got key resistance levels coming from the 1.30 and 1.31 handles, although prices at the moment are still quite a distance from July's 10-month high, 1.3266. If prices were to drop back below 1.28, that could potentially accelerate declines towards the 200 MA that's currently at 1.2664. But for the moment, we are seeing the pair being rather neutral. Looking at the finally, let's look at the Australian dollar and the US dollar. Prices have been consolidating since the high, the two-year high we saw back in late July, 0.8065. The 0.80 handle has been hard to break since dropping below that in early August. We can see it is it has provided a resistance several times, and at the moment though we are seeing support being provided from around the 0.7945 area. Below that we have 0.7868. That's been acted as support several times since late July. A drop below that level, we would see the August 8-week low of 0.7807 coming into focus. So a drop below the 0.78 handle would significantly weaken the positive bias, both in the short term and in the long term. Although in the short term, it is closer to being neutral, but nevertheless, prices have managed to hold above the Ichimoku cloud despite consolidating since late July. That's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and have a great day.